الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاة حي على الفلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، يقول سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. I ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the turner of the hearts, to keep our hearts steadfast on his deen. Ameen, رب العالمين. Respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the Hakim and He is the Khabir. He is the all wise and He is the all aware. And He is the only one who can make people or places or timing Mubarak, blessed. Neither myself nor you nor anyone on earth can decide to make a place Mubarak or a person Mubarak or a time Mubarak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy, out of His greatness, out of His generosity, every once in a while He give us seasons of ibadah to bring us close to Him. There are the 5 daily prayers. There is the Jumu'ah, the weekly ibadah. There is Ramadan, once in a year. And there is the Hajj, once in a lifetime. There are some days that are coming up. Bi-idhnillah, either Sunday coming up or Monday. Depends on the moon sighting and depends on the start of the month of Dhul Hijjah. These days, many, many people either ignore or they are not aware of their importance. The first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. What make them so important and so great? For many reasons. Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Surah that we all know by heart. Allah swore by the Fajr, and then after that, He swore by لَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu wa ardaa, he said, this لَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ is the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And the greatest only swears by what's great. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to swear by these days, that means they are extremely important. In another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the appointed days. The ulama said the appointed days are the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. These 10 days are the only time of the year, the only time of the year that the 5 pillars of Islam meet. You could pray, give zakat, fast any day. But this is the only time of the year you could have Hajj. So this is the only time of the year that Hajj and fasting and sadaqat and charity and salat, and of course, if you are not a muwahid, you don't care about the others. They all meet in this season, in these 10 days. And in these 10 days, there is the day of Arafah, which is the 9th of Dhul Hijjah. In this day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, this is the most day that Allah save next from the hellfire. May Allah save our next from the hellfire. In these 10 days, there is the official best day of the year, Yawmul Nahr. The best day of the year is the day of Eid al-Adha, Yawmul Nahr, the day of sacrifice. Another reason, another evidence that shows us the importance of these days is the hadith, the very popular, famous hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is narrated in many, many different ways. I will give you the narration in Bukhari. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام ما من أيام العمل الصالح أحب إلى الله من العمل في الأيام العشر. أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, no days
No days that the righteous deeds are more beloved to Allah than the deeds done on those 10 days. Personally, I think every masjid on earth this Friday should be, this is their khutbah. Because we are so involved in dunya matters. Who's gonna remind me of the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah? CNN? Who's gonna remind me of this great season that's coming up? In few days they're gonna come. A brother called me last Sunday. He's very cautious on taking advantage of every season. He asked me, brother, I want to make sure when the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are going to start. So I told him, inshallah, Sunday or Monday. He called me from overseas, very concerned. Last night I got a phone call, he passed away. Wallahi. Some of you know him. Brother Musa from Bayshore, the guy who used to take care of the masjid. He passed away last night. He called me from Mali to ask me how he knows the value. He knew the value, subhanAllah. So my brothers and sisters, Brother Musa, may Allah make him from the people of Jannah, was preparing, was very concerned about the start of these days. And subhanAllah, he never made it to witness them. So my dua and your dua from now on, Ya Allah, keep me alive to witness these days. They might be the last time, or we might even not make it. We might follow Musa. We might not even make it till Sunday. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me and you to witness them, let's have a plan. Ma min ayyam, no days. When Rasulullah ﷺ said no days means no days. That means 355 days are on the side and those 10 days on another side. Including Ramadan? Yes, including Ramadan. Because Rasulullah ﷺ, he did not say مَا مِنْ أَيَّامِ الْعَمَلِ الصَّالِحِ except Ramadan. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said that means the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are better than the last 10 days of Ramadan. But the nights of the last 10 days of Ramadan are better because they have Laylatul Qadr in them. But the daytime, subhanAllah, is better. So I want you to feel what are we about to witness. The Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, not even jihad fi sabilillah. Not even jihad fi sabilillah is better than the actions in these days. He said, not even jihad fi sabilillah, except one situation, one case is better than the a'mal in these days. Is a person who leave with himself and his wealth and he never comes back. He dies fi sabilillah. So your salat, yani if someone went to fight in the cause of Allah and he came back with one eye, with one arm, with one leg, your amal in these days is better than his fighting. Your salat in these days is better than his fighting. Because the only exception that Rasulullah ﷺ gave is a person that goes and never comes back. And another hadith, Rasulullah ﷺ in this hadith, he said, the most beloved. In another hadith, he said, superior, azka. Another hadith, afdal. In another hadith, a'zam, greatest. He used the best of words to explain the weight and the value and the importance of these days. If I know that something with that vital importance coming up, I'm gonna have to prepare. Because al-a'mal bin niyat, actions are by intentions. So even if I make my intentions, I make my plan, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took my soul before these days, inshallah I will be rewarded on everything on that list. First, Tawbah. Before those 10 days start, we have one more day. Tawbah. Repent, ya akhi. Only Allah knows how many sins we have committed from the end of Ramadan till now. 2 months. Repent. Cleanse the heart, the source of reception. Clean it before the season comes. And this Tawbah is for every Muslim. For every mu'min. A lot of people think that the Tawbah is only for the major sinners. No, the Tawbah is for me. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu tubu ila Allah.
The ayah started by all who you believe. Not ya kuffar, ya munafiqeen. All who you believe, repent to Allah.
Repent, ya akhi. From every single sin. Second, the best ibadah ever to be done in these days is Hajj, no doubt. I know some of us here, some people have left already, and others are leaving today or tomorrow, maybe the beginning of next week maximum. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your Hajj, ya akhi. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant the Hajj for every brother and sister who did not go yet. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. The best amal to be done in these days is Hajj. My brother, if the shaitan has been playing with your mind for years and making you postpone the Hajj year after year till you get your child married, till the child graduate, till you have a grandchild, till this, till that, till you're 50, till you're 60, and you keep delaying it while you are capable financially and physically, you are committing a major sin. A major sin. Wallahi, do not delay it, ya akhi. Do not delay it. If you are able, you have the money, and you have the health, you are one of very few that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them and permitted them to go visit His house. There are millions of Muslims that wish to have your money and your health so they can go to Hajj. And you have it, and you keep delaying the Hajj. Why, ya akhi? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? The minute those two are available, jump immediately, book, hurry up. Do not keep delaying it, because you never know when you will go. Third, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in another narration of the same hadith that started the same thing, when he said, no days are better or more beloved to Allah than these 10 days, then he said, فَأَكْثِرُوا. Abundantly say, تَهْلِيل, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, تَكْبِير, اللَّهُ أَكْبَر, تَسْبِيح, سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ. This is a sunnah that has been neglected and deserted. We only think that the takbir is only for Eid. Abu Bakr, Umar radiyallahu anhu and Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu, an al-Sahaba ajma'in, they used to walk in the market in these 10 days. From the beginning of those 10 days, they walk in the market. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Wa lillahi alhamd. All through the 10 days. This is a sunnah that's neglected. Revive it, ya akhi. Be the one who revives it. And every time somebody does it because of you, you will be rewarded bi-idhnillah. While you leave to work, while you're coming to the masjid, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Keep remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is just a form of remembrance. But you could do any form of remembrance. Any form of remembrance of Allah. Remember, ya akhi. If you study that hadith very well, you will find out that every salat is done in these 10 days is better than the salat done in the rest of the 355 days. Any $100 you gave in these 10 days is better than any money you have given in the whole year.
Any day you fast is better than the whole year. This is the hadith. مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ. No days that the amal is more beloved to Allah than these days. So every action. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ إِنَّ لَا نُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلٍ.
Surah Al-Kahf that you read today, in that surah Allah said, the righteous, the believers who do righteous deeds, we will never let any of their actions go to waste. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all through the day. While you're driving, while you're working, all day long, do not waste this time. Do not waste a second of these 10 days. Not a second. Be extremely grateful if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept you alive to witness them. That's a sign that Allah loves you. He wants you to come closer to Him. And the way to come close to Allah is by increasing the righteous deeds. By doing what Allah loves. And I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I want Allah to love me. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told me, the actions on these days are so beloved to Allah. So I'm not gonna waste any moment without performing any kind of ibadah just to gain bi-idhnillah the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. اللهم بلغنا العشر من ذي الحجة يا رب العالمين، واجعلنا فيهم من الصائمين والقائمين والمتصدقين، آمين رب العالمين. My brothers and sisters, one of the longest ibadat you could ever do and one of the heaviest ibadat that we can ever do is fasting. On that schedule, I have on the top of that list that I will fast the whole 9 days. All of them! All of them!
We just did it 2 months ago till 8:30, no problem. Now 2 hours discount. 6:30. 9 days we go like this, wallahi. And every day you fast fi sabilillah, not to show off. It's tougher on the Hijjah than Ramadan, much tougher. Why? In Ramadan everybody's fasting. It's easy. In Ramadan the shayateen are chained.
It's easier. Now the shaitan is going to come and tell you, why you have to fast? It's optional. Alhamdulillah, you fasted Ramadan. You don't have to fast now.
Just like our brothers and sisters are throwing stones on the shayateen. Throw stones here when he tells you to stop the ibadat. Kick the shaitan out of your life. Fast the whole 9 days. The whole 9 days. Whosoever fast 1 day في سبيل الله بعد الله بينه وبين جهنم 70 خريفا.
Whosoever fast 1 day في سبيل الله, very underlined, for the sake of Allah, Allah will keep his way away from hell, his face away from hell, 70 years. 9 times 70, Allahu Akbar. All 9 days, ya akhi. All 9 days, my sister, encourage your family. You are the mother of the house. Encourage the whole family. Make it a beautiful gathering at home. Revive the sunnah of Ramadan. Show the kids from now. When we were growing up, wallahi, I have no clue what Dhul Hijjah is. No clue. Let's change that by establishing it in our children's mind so they could look forward for these days and appreciate them and honor them. 9 days. If you can't for one reason or another,
Your intention to do them بإذن الله. But if you can't, make sure you do not miss the ninth. That's the day of Arafah. That's the day of Arafah. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whosoever fast that day, Allah will forgive one past year and one coming year of sins. La ilaha illallah. How can I miss it, ya akhwan? Wallahi, I have a lot of sins. A lot of sins, all of us. And I have these opportunities. How can I waste them? If your boss tells you, 10 days at work, 10 days at work, and if you concentrate and you finish, you work every day 15 hours, after you finish the 10 days, $100,000 cash. Wallahi, you will sleep in the office. You will sleep in the office. You will not leave anything. You will make sure everything is perfect. But when it comes to the umur of Akhirah, Ya Allah, nobody cares. Subhanallah. Why, Ya Akhi, why? Who gave you the guarantee you're going to live another day? Every day. There are 3 janazas in Dar al-Quran this weekend. Today, tomorrow, and after tomorrow. 3 janazas. Wallahi, they did not know that they're going to go. None of them. Just like me and you. This could be my last khutbah. This could be your last Jumu'ah. Make the intention. You will fast on Arafah. And on that day, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم taught us what is the best dua you could ever make. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. 100, 200, 1,000, 10,000 times. He said that's the best. That means it's the best dua on that day. Repeat it as much as you can. Quran. Make an intention. We have a group of brothers. We decided in these 10 days we're going to finish the whole Quran and reading. Wallahi, we can do it. Make your intention. Every letter is 10 hasana. Make the intention you will read the whole Quran these 10 days. Pick a surah, ya akhi, and memorize it. Pick a surah, ya akhi, and know what it means. One surah. Feel like those 10 days, something have changed in you spiritually. Something, one thing. One thing. Qiyam al-layl. The days are getting shorter and the nights are getting longer. The Salaf, they used to say, الشتاء ربيع المؤمن. Winter is the spring of the believer. The days are short, he fasts, and the night are long, he's up. Every true believer loves winter. Soon, in a couple of weeks, when they bring the hour back, Maghrib will be 4:30, 5 o'clock. Wallahi, ya akhwan, take advantage. Fast, make qiyam. Qiyam al-layl, 2 rak'ah, whatever you can. But these 10 days, every night, Fajr's at 5:30, get up at 5. 5 o'clock, 2 rak'ah. Enjoy them slowly. Long sajda. You just prayed 2-3 hours behind the imam in Ramadan, no problem. Just 5-10 minutes of 2 rak'ah. أفضل الصلاة بعد الفريضة. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, the best salat after fard is قيام الليل. Can you imagine? Some brothers used to say, always say, I wish I was a Sahabi. Don't know. Brother, be careful what you're wishing for. There's a lot of Sahaba who saw Rasulullah ﷺ, they left the deen. And there's a lot of Sahaba, when the Qiyam was prescribed, it was fard first. You don't know if you can handle it to be a Sahabi. Allah knows what's best for you. I know we say this because we love Rasulullah ﷺ, but be very careful. Allah knows what you can handle. Qiyam was a must in the beginning, was a fard before the Salat became a fard, then became optional. Now when it's optional, let's perform 2 rak'ah only. Just 2 rak'ah. Alone. you and Allah. And before you perform this two rak'ah, my brother, go to your wife and wake her up. Wake up your children for qiyam, just those 9 days. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, رحم الله امرئ قام من الليل. Allah will have mercy on a man who gets up in the middle of the night and he wakes up his wife to pray. And same thing for the wife, my sister. Wake up your husband gently and let him pray qiyam. The Sahaba used to divide the night into three. One night the father, one third the father, one third the mother, one third the children. The house is always vibrating with dhikr. Any amal salih, smiling with your brother's face is a sadaqah. Giving charity these days. All our brothers all over the world are in need. Send them anything. Put a joy on their face. Wallahi, the sadaqah done in these days is better than sadaqah done in the whole year. Give them, ya akhi. Maybe they need money for the Eid. Maybe they need money to eat and drink. Allah has given you. Give, give back. It will come back multiplied many, many folds, bi-idhnillah. And finally, my brothers, whomsoever amongst you is intending to sacrifice, if you are intending to sacrifice, which is most of us, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the hadith is in Sahih Muslim, you're not allowed to cut your nails or take any hair of any part of your body starting from the beginning of the Hijjah till the Eid, which is, if Sunday is the first of the Hijjah, that means from Maghrib of Saturday, that's it. So if you need a haircut, you want to cut your nails, you got to do it today or tomorrow up to Maghrib. And this is only for the brothers who are intending to sacrifice. Their wives and their children has nothing to do with it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people who witness these days and work hard in these days. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the little that we do. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply it many, many, many folds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with sincerity in our sayings and in our actions. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawmi al-kafirin. Allahumma ansur al-muslimin fi kulli makan. Allahumma rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa dhurriyatina qurrata a'yun واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. Brothers and sisters, on the day of judgment, the Muslim feels sorry and the non-Muslim feels sorry. The non-Muslim, he feels sorry that he did not believe. And the Muslim feels sorry he did not take advantage of every single moment to come close to Allah. Let's take advantage of these days. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. Inna Allah wa malaikatah yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا على الصلاة هيا على الصلاة هيا على الفلاح هيا على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
استووا اعتدلوا. الله أكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا. الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. One of the brother, Aleem Backus, he passed away yesterday. Allah give them Jannatul Firdaus, inshallah. Brother Saif and Zakia Khatun, they are both sick. Requesting for a dua, may Allah give them good health and speedy recovery, inshallah. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار Our friends and parents and relatives, those who passed away from this world, may Allah forgive their all kabira, sagira sins and grant them in Jannatul Firdaus and make their grave spacious, inshallah. Oh Allah, give us a tawfiq to at least fast the 10 days or 9 days of Zilhijjah, inshallah, or at least the 9th of Zilhijjah, inshallah. Rabbana wa la tuhammilna ma la taqata lana bi, wa'fu anna, waghfir lana, warhamna. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين